Are you looking for two simple ways to increase your confidence and become more effective with your business conversion? Tune in to Agent Hacks right now. Welcome back to Agent Hacks. I'm going to go over something today that I find is so critical, so important that it shouldn't just be something that we implement during the current climate. Rather, this should become part of your daily routine because this is what high achievers do. This is what people do that want to get better, want to climb the mountain, and we all know the higher that we climb, the more treacherous the terrain gets. So the first thing, and this is going to be pretty basic stuff. That's the beauty of all this. There's no magic bullets when you're building a business, is daily role play with your scripts and dialogues. And what I mean by that is you're probably saying to yourself, Tom, I know the scripts. I don't need to go over it. I've got them up in front of me. And I'm going to respectfully tell you, you can never practice enough. And you're probably wrong. And that sort of belief is holding you back. What I mean by that is that when you practice, the more you practice, the more confident you get. And when you're confident, your nerves are less likely to get in the way when you perform in front of your clients, meaning performing the presentation, using the script, using the dialogues over the phone. And confidence is going to make you feel good. And practicing is going to ensure that you sound and look good when you're performing. So think about this, not from a business standpoint, think about athletes. You think those guys and those gals, they don't get jitters when they walk on the court or get on the field? Of course they do. And because they practice so much, and the ones that practice the most, they're the ones that have the least amount of nerves and perform in the clutch. Those folks, just no different than a band, you know, rock star, pop star, whatever you want to call it, those people practice all the time so that they can perform night in and night out. And we should be doing the same thing. So I'm going to give you an example here of two NBA players. One practiced so hard, he would get in fights with his teammates. He would push them to the limit because he practiced like he wanted to play. And that's Michael Jordan, debatably the greatest basketball player of all time. And there's a local guy here from Philadelphia. You might remember his press conference. We talking about practice, not a game, but practice. Allen Iverson, he's a Hall of Famer. He was really good. Is he an all-time great? We all know the answer, unfortunately, and I'm a big fan of both of these guys. Huge fan of Allen Iverson. He could have been a lot better and left a lot of meat on the bone because he didn't put the time in when nobody was looking. That's the key difference there. He'd leave it all on the court during the game, which is great. How are you going to get better if you're not practicing? And practicing is going to give you confidence, so when those tough objections come at you in the presentation, so when you are sitting there and you're in a deep negotiation with a seller, when you're confident, cool, calm, and collective, you're going to win. You're going to be able to get that agreement signed, win that client, and that's what we're all looking to do here. So that's number one, is daily role play. And remember, the goal of role play is to talk to less people and set more appointments, which is going to increase your effectiveness. Number two, you want to have two accountability partners. One around your health and vitality, and one around the key leading indicators in your business, those KPIs, those key performance indicators. There's a lot of different names for them. We all know what they are. The activities that move your business that you have 100% control over. And the accountability partner should be no different than the role play, meaning you get on these calls, you talk about what you need to talk about, and then you hang up the phone. This is not to be meant to be, excuse me, hey, how's your family doing? Oh, I had this client that was blah, blah, blah. That doesn't work. That's not the intention here. The role play, you get on and you get off. Same thing with the accountability. The reason you want to have accountability around your health is because rarely do you see a high achiever that does not focus on their health and vitality. No matter how you're going to do that, if it's going plant-based with your diet, if it's doing yoga, if it's riding a Peloton bike, hey, doesn't matter. You've got to have some sort of discipline around that. And if the people aren't holding you accountable that you're counting on, you need to find another accountability partner. Same thing with those things that move the needle in your business. You have to make commitments. I want to make 100 calls today. The commitment should be specific and measurable. And then you hold each other accountable and ask what got in the way or what you could do better. And that person is on your team. They are on your side. And that's why you need two of them. because your health and vitality partner may not be the same person as the guy or gal who's going to hold you accountable with your business. So those two things, you implement those. We all know that what we track and measure improves. We all know that the more confident you are, the more you're going to convert. And confidence can be defined as how strongly you believe in your capabilities to learn new skills, perform at a certain level, attain a goal, or achieve your own definition of success. It's probably the most important psychological contributor to performance in the business world, because it doesn't matter if you've got ability. I've met a ton of people that had a lot of skills and were talented, but if they don't believe in themselves to have that ability, then the ability will never get used to its fullest extent. So you got to use confidence, you got to track and measure, hold each other accountable, and make sure you're practicing. Packed a lot in there. Any questions, let me know. Otherwise, we'll be back next week.